Hey guys, welcome back to Top 10 Nerd. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie. Following the incredible success of the Deadpool film, nerds and nerds alike are flocking towards the anti-hero. Anti-heroes have always been my favorite heroes because they're not constrained by the same goody-two-shoes set of rules that other heroes are. Namely, they have no problem killing bad guys. Whether you want a refresher or you're looking for new anti-heroes to follow, this is the video for you. Here's my list of Top 10 comic book anti-heroes. Number 10, Judge Dredd. Judge Joseph Dredd is a law enforcement officer in Mega City 1, a city in North America in a dystopian future. While some heroes on this list are considered anti-heroes because their morality is kind of in a gray area, Judge Dredd is here because his morality is absolute and brutal. Dredd's often viewed as the personification of blind justice, and his actions show this when he convicts, sentences, and executes criminals. Number 9, The Comedian. Edward Morgan Blake is a vigilante hero and member of the Watchmen, who is characterized by his affable personality and charm. Although the comedian fights for the side of good, he's also a straight up jerk. I would love him as a hero since I love wisecracking superheroes, but it's one thing he did that I just can't get past, which is his attempted rape of Sally Jupiter, the Silk Spectre. For me, I'm fine with anti-heroes killing bad guys and looking out for themselves. You know, you can be selfish all you want, but if you do something as evil as the comedian tried to do, I just can't like you anymore. But maybe the fact that I respect him as a hero, but hate him as a person means that he was actually perfect in the anti-hero role, which is why he's on this list. Number 8, Moon Knight. Mark Spector took on the mantle of Moon Knight after being revived by the moon god Khonshu. This one's kind of tricky because recently Moon Knight has taken a bit of a break from the whole killing thing, but he has enough dead bodies in his past for me to still consider him an anti-hero. Plus, the line, "I wear white so they can see me coming," is just super awesome. Almost as good as Deadpool's, "He has the right idea. He wore the brown pants." While Moon Knight, or White Batman as some people call him, is pretty tame for an anti-hero, he's done some pretty messed up stuff, like, I don't know, cutting off his enemy's face. But other than the face cutting, he's a pretty good guy. Number 7, Lobo. Lobo is somewhat less known than others on this list, but he is basically the epitome of the anti-hero. Although he was originally revealed as a villain, this alien biker mercenary was later brought back to life as a grim and gritty anti-hero, comparable to the Punisher, but grungier because the 90s. Fans quickly latched on to Lobo, and he's been a part of many teams and series since he was revived. Gifted with super speed, strength, stamina, and intelligence, as well as incredible healing and immortality, Lobo is pretty strong and super intimidating. Number 6, Venom. When an alien symbiote attached itself to Eddie Brock, Venom was born. While traditionally viewed as a villain, Venom has become something of an anti-hero in more recent years, often teaming up with Spider-Man to defeat more powerful villains like Carnage. Venom doesn't always choose the evil route. He still does have a rather strong urge to protect the innocent, and he does this both alongside Spider-Man and Solo. That said, when he does catch the bad guy, that guy is in for a world of hurt. Probably death. Painful death. Although apparently they're coming out with a solo film for Venom, which will be pretty cool. I hope they do it well. Number 5, Rorschach. Similar to Judge Dredd, Rorschach's anti-hero nature stems from his absolute sense of good and evil. Rorschach knows exactly what he thinks is acceptable and will do what is correct and good, regardless of the consequences to himself or others. An example of this is his refusal to be quiet about Ozymandias' plan, even though he knew it was for the greater good. While personally, I'm generally more attracted to characters who live in shades of gray, there's something so interesting about a guy who's so concerned with morality, who also decapitates dogs and burns people alive. Number 4, The Punisher. Frank Castle actually wanted to be a priest, but his inability to forgive people stopped that in its tracks. So he joined the Marines and went to Vietnam. Soon after his return to the US, his wife and two kids are murdered by the mafia. And when the law fails to deal with the killers, Castle decides he needs to take justice into his own hands and becomes the Punisher. I'm a huge Punisher fan because he has such a cool contrast between high moral standards and a very hands-on, almost amoral approach to dealing with the crime. Plus, John Bernthal is the frickin' man. Number 3, Wolverine. This might be a bit controversial because Wolverine's a bit less anti than the other anti-heroes on this list, but I think he totally qualifies. Logan hates working with others, he has a much looser moral code, and has been known to slice people in half. It's harder to see the anti-hero nature in the recent films since he's often stuck taking on a more conservative, heroic persona, but especially in Logan, you get to see his disdain for regular heroics. Hopefully the next person to play Wolverine nails this side of the character as well. Number 2, Spawn. When you think anti-hero, a few names probably come to mind. Chances are, one of those names is Spawn. He worked for the CIA for much of his life. After dying and being sent to hell due to the acts he committed while in the CIA, Simmons is returned to life in a demonic form. Spawn spends most of his life either stopping bad guys or trying to keep the forces of heaven and hell from destroying the earth. With an ever-changing supersuit and extremely gray morals, Spawn makes for a classic and powerful anti-hero. Number 1. Deadpool. Of course. I don't have to tell you about everyone's favorite mercenary because he's everyone's favorite. But Deadpool is just such an amazing character. Sure, his mutation is cool, he's an amazing fighter, but the real reason we all love him is his attitude. Kicking bad guy butt is always good, but kicking bad guy butt while soaring through the air, calling him an idiot and simultaneously mooning another bad guy is even better. I can't freaking wait for the next Deadpool movie. I recently rewatched it and it was even better than I remember. Now, I did mention in another video that Deadpool's on Netflix and everyone got mad, so let me clarify, it's on Canadian Netflix. Because Canada's the best, and Deadpool's Canadian. Honestly, I'm wondering if it was done as kind of a joke about Deadpool being Canadian, because it's pretty much the only movie that only we have. Yeah, finally we get to win. That's it for today, guys. If you enjoyed the video, please drop a like down below and subscribe to see more videos. Plus, if you want a notification when we upload new videos, hit that bell icon. Want a part 2? Did I miss your favorite antihero? Let me know in the comments section, or hit me up on Twitter at Ron_McKenzie_. Until we meet again, later, nerds.